Globe Telecom's venture builder, one of the largest in Southeast Asia, 917 Ventures, is making a big push for women empowerment, supporting women-led startups. The number? 42%. That is the percentage of team members, venture builders, and CEOs who are women. Today, we meet one of those women, Stephanie Kubota of Fresh Technologies. She's actually creating a trailblazing technology enabling F&B digitalization with over, I'm updating the number, 1,700 merchant partners and over 8 million registered customers. Stephanie, happy Women's Month and welcome to Market Edge.
Hi, Mimi. Good morning. Happy Women's Month.
All right.
Thank you for having me.
Thank you for joining us. So Stephanie, you are an all-in-one e-commerce platform. So why don't you walk us through, give us a 60-second pitch for Rush Technologies and how you're powering stores and winning customers for your partners.
Right. So Rush is an e-commerce and loyalty software as a service. We provide an out-of-the-box solution for digitalization in the Philippines, primarily for the F&B industry. So we provide their e-commerce stores, their loyalty programs, and really help them journey through their digitalization with every step of the way.
How old is this startup?
So we were incubated in 917 Ventures in 2019, and then we were officially spun off and incorporated in 2021. So right now, officially, we are 3 years old, or 4 years old, sorry.
And are you breaking even? Are you in the black, or how many more years to go?
Right. I'm very happy to say that we are very close to our profitability this year. That's actually one of our biggest goals, to hit EBITDA positive by the end of 2024.
Exciting times ahead. Good for those who have invested in you. So just very quickly, I was going over some of the stats from your company, and you say that in 2023, Rush-backed e-commerce platforms or stores saw three times more sales. How did you do that?
Right. So when we were in 2019, we were primarily serving the medium to large enterprise sector of the Philippines. And of course, when the pandemic hit, we saw an opportunity to really expand our services into e-commerce, as well as expand our target market into the small and medium-sized businesses. And that's where we really saw growth, and we saw a much bigger impact for the MSMEs with digitalization. We lowered down our prices, we reverse engineered it to make sure it's the lower, the barrier for entry is much lower for them. We also handhold them in operationalizing the system into their day-to-day business.
All right. So talk to us about the business model. How do you make money from this? How do MSMEs, for example, let's just say MSMEs, get into your fold, get your services?
So we are a SaaS platform, so it's monthly subscription based. Right now, it's based on the number of branches you have. So unlike most SaaS platforms that have limitations on the number of products that you put in or the number of registered user base, we do it as a pay as you grow kind of model. So it's really based on the scale of the business. And there are, of course, other revenue streams that we have for ancillary services. Being backed by Globe, we have the systems advantages of being able to create an ecosystem of end-to-end services, from SMS messaging all the way down to advertising to data enrichment. So all of that we put into our platform and offer it to our partners.
Stephanie, there are so many companies offering the same services as you. What makes you different? What makes you stand out?
I think exactly what I said, right? It's really creating that ecosystem. So I think e-commerce and loyalty is the foot in the door to digitalization. After that, there's so many other steps. E-commerce is primarily just the digitalization and access for end users, right? But we are about to introduce a lot more technology that can help make the back end operations of things a lot more efficient. So that's kind of where we, I guess, the advantages of being in an ecosystem is being able to adopt all of these new technologies from our so-called brothers and sisters within the technology space, and offering it in an affordable price for our partners.
All right. And of course, do you also get to leverage the massive amount of data that Globe Telecom has to be able to do precision marketing when you do loyalty programs, for example?
Not directly, but of course, our platform is integrated into Globe's lifestyle super apps like GCash and Globe One. So there, our merchants are able to expose their brands to, I think right now, 90 million users through exposing their online stores there, rewards program, and of course, placing their advertising and promotions into the ad placements inside those super apps.
Mm-hmm. And when you're merchant partners get your service, is it supposed to be exclusive? Like, you're the only SaaS provider that they work with, or can they get you and get others as well? Because I'm looking at your brands, these are very big brands. The Bistro Group is part of your network, Wildflower, for example, so many big names. So are these exclusive partnerships, or they can get, you know, whoever, how many ever that they want?
Yeah, so we're completely non-exclusive. Of course, our merchants are open to partner with any other software as a service companies. In fact, we do this a lot. We have integrated ourselves into multiple POSs and CRM platforms. So it really is creating a supplementary bond or a symbiosis with other softwares that, I guess, makes us unique as a partner.
Mm-hmm. All right. And final question, it's Women's Month. I wonder, How do you, as a woman yourself, who founded a startup that's growing massively, how do you think women can help empower other women by, you know, bringing tech to women and bringing women to tech? There are not a lot of women in tech. I mean, look at the number of women taking STEM courses. What do you think is your role? Okay, I think go ahead.
Oh. Let me know if I'm clear.
You're clear. Okay. Go ahead.
Well, around 50% of the workforce are female in the Philippines. But again, as you mentioned, around only 22% are females within STEM. And I think as much as we can contribute during the workforce recruitment, career development area, it really starts at the beginning, right? Introducing STEM into education and representing, because women are very underrepresented within the tech space. If you think about tech giants, it's usually Jeff Bezos or Elon Musk. But people forget the likes of Bumble founders or Melanie Perkins of Canva. It's really representing these women at the beginning of their education and showing them that there is a career path inside technology. And similarly, when they are recruited, when women go through the phases of their life, it's providing that work-life balance based on the priorities of their life. So, for example, in Rush, we have a hybrid working environment where our female homemakers are able to spend time with their families as well as prioritize their work at the same time. So I really think it's just saying women can have it all. It's not easy, but it's possible.
And on that note, women can have it all. Thank you so much for joining us, Stephanie. It's a pleasure to speak with you. And thank you for the remarkable things you're doing for women all over the country.
Thank you so much for having me, Mimi.
All right.